Hello, my name is Steve Otto, and I'm an audiologist specifically working with recipients of the Multichannel Auditory Brainstem Implant, or ABI for short. If you're an ABI candidate, a family member, or an interested friend, this information was designed especially for you. Candidates for the ABI are individuals with bilateral auditory nerve tumors. It's a condition called neurofibromatosis type 2, or NF2. Removal of these tumors often results in deafness. The ABI is designed to restore sound to individuals who have undergone tumor surgery. This presentation will cover many facets of ABI implantation. I'll show you the device, explain its benefits and limitations, and the involvement that's required by the recipient. You'll then meet three ABI recipients who will share their experiences. You'll see a variety of results, but these individuals had one thing in common. They were all motivated to make the most of the sound they received with their ABI. We hope this information will help your understanding of the device. The ABI is based on cochlear implant technology. Like a cochlear implant, the ABI is designed to electrically stimulate hearing nerves. However, it's important to understand that the ABI is not the same as a cochlear implant. The cochlear implant stimulates the inner ear, while the ABI directly stimulates hearing nerves in the brain. The ABI was specifically designed for patients deafened from NF2 who cannot use cochlear implants. Now let's talk about how the ABI works. A receiver stimulator and an electrode array are implanted during a surgical procedure, usually during acoustic tumor removal. About 6 weeks to 2 months after surgery, external equipment is fitted and the device is activated for the first time. This is how the device works. The external equipment consists of a speech processor and a microphone headset. Sound is picked up by the microphone and is sent through a cable to the speech processor, where it's converted to tiny electrical impulses and then sent back up the cable to the transmitter coil on the scalp. By radio link, the implant receiver under the skin is activated, and the sound impulses are delivered to the electrodes on the array. The electrodes then stimulate small groups of auditory neurons in the brainstem, which is interpreted as sound. In the clinic, each electrode is tested. In addition to hearing sensations, it's common for patients to experience mild, non-auditory sensations on some electrodes. Often these are tingling sensations that can be eliminated during processor programming.
All right, what's it feel like?
Just not a sharp pain, just a, like a nerve, just a little
twinge.
Tweak. Yeah.
Tweak. Okay.
They also often decrease with time.
Okay, now I'm going to test on each electrode.
ABI recipients offer a wide range of responses in describing what they initially hear. Often the sound is characterized as low-pitched tones or muffled sounds.
It's between them and me.
All right, well, I can come up a little.
Go up one more and see.
Some describe the sounds as beeping, bell-like.
That's good.
Or buzzing. And some ABI recipients even experience a combination of all these sounds.
Comfortable?
Comfortable. Yeah. Don't feel anything?
No.
Okay.
Hood.
Particularly at first, patients report that speech and other sounds are not at all clear or normal through the ABI.
Head.
With experience, this gradually improves as the brain learns to interpret the new sounds.
Would you like to eat dinner now?
Would you like to do something now?
Is that too loud?
Yeah, turn it down. I could hardly hear your voice over that. It sounded like a nundling.
Is that better?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's important to remember that even the best performing ABI users still encounter difficulty in some communication situations. It's also important to accept that ABI performance typically provides lower levels of speech perception than cochlear implants. ABI patients may not be able to understand significant amounts of speech relying only on the sound from their implants. The ABI is most beneficial in communication when the sound is combined with lip reading. Therefore, patients with significant visual impairment may be less likely to experience benefit. Sound perception through the ABI can change over time, so regular follow-up visits are necessary to make sure it's optimized for the best possible sound.
That was great. You got 24%. That's really good.
Unfortunately, there are some patients who do not experience any hearing from the ABI. This may be due in part to tumor damage to the brainstem. Candidates must realize that this is a possibility. In such cases, implanting the patient's opposite side may be an option. Even though patients are diligently counseled, they're often surprised that the sound is not what they expected.
In combination with lip reading, it can be a big help in face-to-face communication.
As an audiologist, I stress the importance of realistic expectations for the ABI. You'll now hear from three ABI recipients with varying levels of performance. They were each counseled about the benefits and limitations of the ABI and believed they had realistic expectations. They were very motivated to make the most of the hearing they received. Though they still have some difficulties in communicating, they illustrate how well they integrated the ABI into their lives. First, you'll meet Gail, a very successful ABI user. She is one of the earliest multi-channel ABI recipients. After becoming deaf, Gail felt isolated and ineffective in her role as mother and wife. This significantly affected her self-image.
Then we used to play cards when I didn't have sound.
It was really hard.
And it wasn't fun. I never knew what you guys were saying.
Well,
I can hear you laugh.
Now we can't make jokes about your card playing anymore.
Is that what you do?
Yes.
My symptoms were severe headaches, dizziness, tinnitus, hearing loss. I was sent to a neurosurgeon after they had done an MRI and some extensive testing. They found bilateral acoustic neuromas. I was already totally deaf in my left ear, and he said I needed brain surgery. I had a total of 6 of these brain surgeries to remove 2 acoustic neuromas.
In 1992, Gail had to have another surgery, and if they performed the surgery, she would be totally deaf, so they then recommended an ABI implant, and with that she would be able to hear again once the tumor was removed.
We decided as a family that it was really the only decision to go for the implant. It was either a life with total silence or some sound. When we went back for the 92 surgery, they were able to remove the tumor, but during surgery I had complications and they had to close up and they were not able to put the implant in. My whole world ended on that day.
We were at church with my grandparents, and they told us after the service that my mother, that the operation didn't go through, and I just remember bawling my eyes out all the way home.
I was totally deaf for 1 year and 9 months. It affected my family very drastically. I felt as though I was being left out because communicating with me wasn't very easy.
She was reading lips, but it was still very difficult. We'd have to write notes, or we'd get so frustrated that we would either stop talking or try and change the subject, and it was extremely difficult.
We always had to have pens on us and pieces of paper to communicate with her, so that was always kind of hard.
I was going through my pre-adolescence or adolescent years, and that's when I needed my mom the most, and because she lost her hearing, I, in a sense, lost part of my mother that I needed.
We wanted her to hear the things that we were doing. We wanted her to hear us talk to her. We wanted to communicate with her, and we couldn't. And we always had to write that down, and I felt like my family wasn't normal, and I wanted a normal family.
They would get upset if they would have to repeat something, or they would just say, "That's okay, never mind."
I would say, "Never mind," and, you know, "I'll tell you later," because it would get too hard for me.
That would hurt me. Desperately, that would hurt me. I felt as though I really wasn't being a good mom. I couldn't be. I couldn't hear. I felt as though they were, take the roles were reversed. That's how I felt. My whole family had to take care of me instead of me taking care of them. And my main goal in life is to take care of my family. They mean more to me than anything.
When we were notified that we could go back to try for the second implant, at that time they removed a portion of a tumor that was left on the left side, and that's when they placed the implant.
When I woke up from that surgery, I knew by the smiles of my family, their faces, that the implant was a success.
I'm connecting this to the computer so we can start.
The audiologist came in with his equipment.
Yeah, this goes on your head.
Tested the implant. I would describe that feeling.
Okay, put your head back
after
down.
Being in total silence for a year and 9 months.
That's terrific.
When I heard that first sound.
That's great, Gail.
It's the greatest miracle that anyone could be able to receive. It changed my life completely.
It was extremely exciting to be able to communicate again, see a smile on her face, as though she was part of it, the human race again, and being able to hear. It made me feel really good because she had waited so long for this.
Hearing my husband's voice and my audiologist's voice and the environmental sounds, the biggest miracle.
First thing I recall what she said, that she can hear the birds twirping, and that was the greatest sound to her after all these years, after all this time that she had been totally deaf.
It's like it brought me back in to the real world, back to my family, back to friends, back to society.
She was so happy to have hearing back. It was the best thing that could have ever happened.
I received this implant approximately 3 months before Christmas, so that Christmas was my first Christmas with sound, and all I wanted to do was listen. I wanted to listen to the ruffle of the paper. I wanted to listen to Christmas bells, family talking. My hearing was my gift for Christmas. That was the only Christmas gift I needed.
She would be involved in conversations. She would be involved with the family again, and the joy and the laughter.
When she got her miracle, it was great for us all because we had our full-time mother back.
our relationship became a lot closer because we could talk to each other more and she could understand more and how I was feeling.
I didn't know it would be this good to be able to sit down and talk with my mom like I've seen so many other people do.
It's very easy to communicate with her now. Over the last few years, we've all noticed that her hearing has increased. She's not reading lips as much. She's relying more on how she hears instead of how she used to be able to communicate while she was deaf.
Okay, now I'm gonna test on each electrode.
My audiologist puts me through extensive testing by giving me different maps to find out how I would pick up sound with those different maps.
That's good.
Hello? Just a minute, Mom.
For her to be able to speak with me on the phone, which was not possible. As a matter of fact, the implant people did not believe that she could speak to me. And we proved them wrong.
Gail?
I talk to my daughter every day on the telephone.
Gail?
Yeah, hi, I'm back.
Oh, good.
How are you?
I'm fine. Isn't it hot today?
Pardon me?
Isn't it hot today? Is it hot out today by your house?
Oh, it's very hot. In fact, we haven't even been swimming.
But I never realized that two women can talk as long as my daughter and my wife. When they get on that phone, boy, there's no ending. There's no ending whatsoever.
My mother is extremely strong, going through so many surgeries and coming through and getting better and hearing so well.
I also have NF2. My mother has given me strength. I was extremely scared for my first brain surgery to remove tumors, and she gave me a lot of strength.
You're a pretty girl.
We received another miracle in our lives 2 weeks ago. Our first granddaughter was born. It really was a joy.
My good night, Kayla.
To hear her cry, to hold her.
I think she loves having a baby in the house again. She raised four of her own kids and she really likes having her around.
I feel extremely confident that she will do a very good job taking care of Kayla while my wife and I are at work.
Thank you so much for babysitting.
You're welcome. No problem. Anytime.
Goodbye, Mom.
Bye, honey.
Are you going to be okay?
Yeah, I'm going to be fine.
Okay, just remember to tickle her tummy when you change her diaper, okay? She likes that.
Okay, I will.
Bye, honey.
Beautiful day today.
Sure is. Yeah.
Birds out.
What? And now I can hear him.
Right.
If I could describe Vaughn in one word, it's a saint on earth. He has never left her side.
Gail's strength to endure the things she has gone through has given me strength. I love Gail with all my heart. 20 years ago when we got married, it was with the wedding vows till death do us part, and that's true. Well, I'll stick with Gail through anything.
What a miracle. Thank you, God. Thank you to everyone who has made this miracle possible. Thank you for giving me my life back.
Gail's story illustrates that the ABI can be highly beneficial in regaining self-confidence. Her story also shows the benefit of good family support and being very motivated to want to hear. We should also note that phone use is typically difficult for ABI users. Gail, however, feels comfortable on the phone with the familiar voice of her mother. Now let's meet Mukunda. He lost his hearing while he was in college. He was completely deaf for more than 15 years before receiving his multi-channel ABI. There was some question about whether he would be able to benefit after being deaf for so long.
When are you planning the opening? Is there a potential date?
We are supposed to open on 28th, that's Tuesday, but no way, I think. Maybe we need 2 weeks.
Another 2 weeks at least.
Minimum.
Yeah. Are the doors going to get...
Which one?
Are the doors going to get some labels?
Some
like
letters?
Mufflers,
some the,
no, nothing. Okay.
In summer of 1981, I had some problems. I mean, like balance-related problems, and I was pretty nervous. And I was also having some hearing problems. Then I went to see a notolaryngologist. After several tests, they found these tumors. It was a big surprise, a shock, I would say. So I was very much concerned about losing my hearing, not about the surgery or life-threatening nature of this. The surgeons advised me that I should go for surgeries right away. So the first one was operated in June 81. After my second surgery, in October 1981, I woke up to complete silence. I was very much depressed. 6 months after I lost my hearing, I was basically spending my time on getting used to this handicap, learning lip reading and other things. I originally came here to do my graduate study in computer science. After I lost my hearing, I was not sure how to go to a graduate school along with the regular students. There was some help the university provided interpreters.
They teach sign language, so we thought it would improve our communication. So we went for 1 year to learn all the signs.
It was very difficult for me to handle the classes. I was missing everything. So she used to go with me to the classes, write the notes for me. At home, she used to sit and write everything. It was a challenging job. I graduated in 85. I work at the University of Iowa Hospitals in the Department of Otolaryngology under cochlear implant projects. I have been in the job since 89.
Have you seen about getting the laser disc encoded?
Getting what?
The laser disc.
Yeah. Okay, looks like the system's stabilized now. Audio part of it. And yeah, my duties at the Department of Otolaryngology is to develop computer systems, hardware and software systems for the cochlear implants project. I'll try to set up a meeting with them. It was about 1994. Doctors found I had a tumor that needs to be removed. It was small, but they said it needs to be removed in 2 years. Between 94 and 96, I started gathering as much information as possible with the help of the research staff in our department. I also started contacting other ABI patients. After gathering all this information, we realized that there is some potential that I can get at least part of my hearing back.
I was also encouraging him to get the implant so that at least he could get some hearing.
My family was involved in this research process. We were discussing this over a period of 2 to 3 years. We were trying to weigh the pros and cons of getting this.
I was more concerned with having him be healthy and safe instead of having some other complication from the ABI make something worse, so I didn't like the idea of him having it at all.
I was kind of skeptical about the ABI at the beginning, but I think all of us began to support it once he had decided that it was something he wanted to do.
I know this is not going to be anything like natural hearing, but we thought if the hearing that I'm going to get is going to help me with lip reading, that will be great. I am deaf for 15 years, that is from 81 through 96. So we took the risk, and fortunately, I'm hearing now. I'm very happy.
This is the first time you've heard voices for 15 years.
We are healed. I was stimulated 6 weeks after my surgery. They were going very slowly, and I started hearing something and I was not sure it was something, maybe I thought it was some psychological feeling. I was not sure if I were hearing or something, but I raised my hand and said, yeah, I am hearing, but I am not sure. And they gradually increasing the current level, and I can feel it, the sound increasing. I don't know, it was excitement. I think I jumped, which you can see it in one of the videos.
I remember he was driving home and we could hear him honking from up the street, and it was just really exciting to know that, you know, he'd gotten his hearing back after so long.
It was a great relief and it was very happy and emotional.
Some sounds like telephone ring sounded very natural. But whereas human voice was very much muffled, it was something like someone had a bad sore throat and talking through a tube or something. Okay. So it wasn't very impressive. Door chime, telephone rang, it was like what I heard before. But the other sounds I had to learn. It was a gradual process, I think. I learned most in the first 6 to 9 months, but now it is kind of leveled off.
Please turn on the coffee.
Please turn on the coffee.
My zipper broke.
Write a note.
They looked up at the blue sky.
Something blue sky.
Be careful driving on the bridge when it's windy.
Something on the bridge.
It seems to me like you're easier to talk to than you used to be.
Uh-huh.
I mean, even easier than 2 years ago.
Okay.
I don't have to repeat very much unless there's background noise.
Okay. Even if I didn't hear this much, I would have been happy. Now I can't remove this device for a minute.
Last week, when we went to Cedar Rapids.
Indianapolis?
In Cedar Rapids.
Indianapolis?
When we went to Cedar Rapids, I was sitting in the back seat. You could hear me, even though it was night. You couldn't see me.
Certainly. In the lab, I think I'm doing about 20% sound alone. Mm-hmm. But that is not a great percentage. But sometimes, I get surprised how well I understand without lip reading.
He's been a really good father because, especially when he was deaf too, he used to come to our concerts, and I'm sure it was so boring to just sit there for 2 hours and not know what was going on.
My daughter has been taking violin classes for the long time.
Now it's just nicer for him because he's able to understand what's going on.
Once I got this, I am delighted to hear she's very good.
Before he used to tell people he was totally deaf, but after the implant he goes tells people he is hard of hearing. He's not totally deaf, he's hard of hearing now. So. You can tell from that.
My confidence level has greatly increased because now I can lip read more and more people with much easily.
Remember them garage door openers were to come over here?
What's that?
The garage door openers were to go at the desk there?
Yeah.
Then they changed.
I am starting Carex muffler and brake. It's an auto service business. In this business, I have 3 other partners, but I will be the one who will be the managing or taking care of day-to-day operations of the company. We plan to open for business in 2 to 3 weeks. You will be finishing this today?
Or Monday. I'll probably come back Monday and finish it.
Okay. Sounds good. There are many things to be accomplished. I have no problem in discussing technical issues with different trades. Because I understand the project very thoroughly.
This looks like about the lowest spot right here. So you'd want a saw cut right through here.
My son Sriraj has been always with me whenever possible. Before I got this implant, he always go with me to help me understand. He will help me with the signing and all that. Now, I don't need much of his help in interpreting, but he helps me with various things, at business and other things.
Hi, Mukunda.
Hi.
Hello.
Very good.
Ready to go for the walk?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So good, the store is finally opening up then.
What is that?
The store is ready to open now. Almost.
Yeah, I think so. Communication has improved tremendously. Second thing is happiness factor. I mean, I enjoy. Just the fact of hearing is very great feeling. I wouldn't have been this successful without the help of friends, family. My wife is a strong woman. She certainly wants me to achieve things that a normal person can achieve. At the same time, I have the determination to achieve, and so far, with the help of God, we are slowly marching on that. This device is working. That too without any side effects. It is certainly helping me on my day-to-day life. I am very happy and I am lucky. There is no doubt about it.
While Mukunda enjoys hearing his daughter play the violin, it's important for ABI candidates to realize that music will sound very different and may not be as enjoyable as they remember. Mukunda also illustrates that it takes time and daily experience to learn to use the ABI. Much of his successful communication combines sounds with lip reading. The ABI has been a useful tool in providing Mukunda with the confidence to open a business where he must interface frequently with employees and the public. Now meet Lori, who was diagnosed with NF2 as a child. She was very resourceful and highly motivated to overcome her challenges. As an ABI candidate, she thought she had clear, realistic expectations of the implant. She, like many recipients, was surprised that it was not quite what she expected.
No way, do you live here?
I do. You live here?
Yes.
In this development?
Yes.
Where?
Like the fifth house on the left.
Get out!
I swear.
How long have you lived here?
I was diagnosed with NF2 when I was 13 years old. At that time, I had problems with my spinal cord and difficulty walking.
Because she was constantly complaining about a severe pain in her lower part of her back.
I had multiple surgeries to take out tumors from my spinal cord.
Once the tumor was removed, she was just back to her normal activities.
Craig and I are high school sweethearts. He was a star football player. I was a homecoming queen. Life was so terrific. It was so hard to believe anything like this was even going to happen to me.
She started having pain in her head, and they found that she did have a tumor then in her, the brain stem. And then it was just been continuous through the years with the surgeries.
I was told by my parents and friends that they thought my hearing was getting bad, that I didn't think it was.
When Lori was losing her hearing, it was kind of a very gradual thing. It's something that you really don't realize. You're talking louder, you're talking more at them. It's something that you do unconsciously.
One day the doctor raised his notes over his mouth and I couldn't understand what he was saying. And we knew then something was really wrong. I was fitted for hearing aids that I still couldn't understand speech. By the time I was 20, I was in the middle of nursing school and hoping that I could finish my college before the hearing would go. It was only a year later that I woke up one morning and my hearing was completely gone. I was dismissed from nursing school and Greg and I separated. our communication was just not working out. He was frustrated, I was frustrated, and I just wanted to shun myself. It was probably one of the lowest times in my life. My parents and family were very supportive. They strongly encouraged me to get education. I turned and had a meeting with a rehab counselor, and they told me about a school in New York, how I could stay in the medical field, and they would teach me how to sign and help me to get in through school. I decided to go there and pursue a career in nuclear medicine.
That period of time for her and I was really an adjustment period for not only myself, but for her as well.
The time of TART, I always had him in my heart and always held on to the hope that someday we'd be together, that I knew I had to learn to accept this and rebuild my life before he could be in it.
When we did get back together, you know, I certainly realized that I still love her. you don't love a person for their hearing.
Although sign language helped me to get through college, I knew once I was out in the real world, I wasn't gonna have someone next to me that could sign all the time. And I did a little bit of research and I learned that the auditory brainstem implant was a device for people like me. The tumor was still intact and the surgery was inevitable. I had to have it done. So I felt if I could do the surgery and get the implant at the same time, it was worth a long shot. A couple of days after the surgery, they hooked me up to a computer, and I remember not hearing anything, and then kept pushing the buttons, and I wasn't hearing anything. And all of a sudden, I hear just deep, deep, deep.
It had been so long that Lori couldn't hear, and all of a sudden, to hear sound again, it's amazing. You know, everybody was elated.
Tears filled my eyes. It was totally the best day in my life. I knew it was gonna work.
I was very happy that the surgery was a success. She can hear something, the tumor's been removed, and we can kind of move on from that point and grow together.
When we came back to have this speech processor hooked up.
When is your aunt getting married?
It was me, Greg, and my parents. And everyone was really excited. We thought, oh, Lori's getting her hearing back. After testing, when are you gonna take out? I was told to go ahead and go that evening to see how I liked it, how it felt. We decided we were gonna go out to dinner, and all I was hearing was noise. I couldn't make out anything anyone was saying. So while everyone's celebrating, I'm thinking, what did I ever get myself into? This is never gonna do me any good. And I didn't want to disappoint anyone. So at the time, I was trying to make good use of it, that I did not like it. And when we get back to the hotel and I turned it off, I felt much better. I was told to give it time. That we, this is a process, things get better as time goes on. You have to get used to it. You have to learn that things don't sound exactly as what I remember them to be. After a while, I realized, okay, that's what the phone sounds like. Not exactly as what I remember it, but that's what it's gonna sound like when it rings. So it was a matter of reteaching myself to hear again. And slowly, it was getting easier. Slowly, I was depending on it and using it more and more. That voices were still just a bunch of gargled noises. After a good year with using the implant, I was able to distinguish voices. I could tell Greg from my parents, from my friends, co-workers or if it's a doctor I'm talking to. It just kept improving, and twice it really started to make sense to me. And that lip reading was just amazingly good. People often told me they couldn't even believe I was deaf.
Are you still on call a lot?
Yeah. July, I tried not to take a lot, but I gotta start making up some time in August. Hello?
Lori.
Kristen.
I've known Lori for, it seems like all my life, but about 15 years, and she's my very best friend.
Do you want to go to lunch or dinner sometime this weekend?
How about Friday?
Thursday?
Friday.
Friday?
Yeah.
I can go after work.
Okay, what time?
About 6:30.
6:30.
All right, if anything changes, just call me back. That otherwise, I'll see you there at 6:30.
All right, I'll see you then.
Okay.
Okay, talk to you later.
Da-da.
Bye-bye.
Soon after I got my ADI, I got a job as a nuclear medicine technologist. VQ? Okay, in ER? A VQ in ER. Okay, I'm gonna call the pharmacy and I'll be there within 45 minutes. Okay, da-da.
That part's done. I just need to ask you a few questions.
I have to meet and talk to Tito every day that I've never seen before.
Can you tell me how tall you are?
6'1".
It's very important that when I do a health history, the information that I take is exactly what they say.
Birth date?
Uh-huh.
10/21/29. October 21, 1929.
They don't fill out horns. I have to verbally take all the intonation.
Okay.
I have to alert to nauditors. The patient's IV is going off. While the patient's being scanned, I'm sitting at a computer that I'm not always facing the patient or the nauditor. There is no doubt about it. Without my implant, I would not have my job. I couldn't do it. I could not put someone else's life in jeopardy because of my disability.
It's not hurting your arm at all, is it?
I feel like getting the implant has just changed my life. I love my career.
Hey, what do you have?
I love helping Tito.
I have an 80-year-old now with a history of lung cancer.
Without doing this, I don't know where I'd be today.
And this is the second bone scan.
My best advice that I could give anyone who's considering getting the implant is you have to work with it. You have to return to have the reprocessing done. Every time I returned, I left hearing better.
We saw a lot of deer while driving last night.
We saw a lot of start the other night.
Great.
It takes practice and it takes motivation, and you have to really want to make good use out of it. I don't know if I could have gone through all of this without Greg.
How do you know that?
He is just been
my backbone
through the entire thing.
She's got a fabulous husband who supports her to 100%. With those two working together, they'll be fine. But he's just one beautiful person.
I'm very, very proud of her for never giving up. It would have been very easy to say, well, geez, why me, and kind of lay down, but she never took that attitude. Laura and I have been high school sweethearts, and everything we've been through up till to this point today, you're still my sweetheart.
Lori's spirit, as you can see, is indomitable. It's important to note that her phone use, particularly a cell phone, is very unusual for ABI recipients. She effectively uses a strategy which includes a prearranged set of questions that require a simple response. This technique allows her to control the conversation by restricting the number of questions and possible responses. The ABI has given Lori the capacity to work in a fast-paced, highly responsible healthcare position. Through her perseverance and positive attitude, her performance has continued to improve greatly, even after 5 years of use. The ABI users you met in this video are considered to have better than average results with their implants. Even so, they worked hard to learn to use their implants, and they still sometimes experience communication difficulty. They've also shown they can continue to improve even after many years of use. It's impossible to predict how much a person is going to benefit from an ABI. Individual results may be better or poorer than those you've seen here. All ABI recipients, however, have contributed greatly to our understanding of the auditory system, and we are extremely grateful for that. They've also shown that it's possible to face the challenges of NF2 and continue with their lifetime plans. For individuals with NF2, the multi-channel auditory brainstem implant can provide a means to enjoy many of life's wonderful sound experiences.